So the story I'm telling today is how the worst day of my life turned into like the best and strangest day of my life. So my mom, sister, and I flew to San Antonio, Texas in February of 2018 to visit my grandparents because they moved there because she was really sick. And so we got our plane tickets home for Sunday morning because my sister and I had to go to school. So my mom was gonna stay until she passed away. But she ended up passing away like 3 a.m. that Sunday. So we had to get on a flight at 11 a.m. that day. And our boarding position was like really, really bad. We had like C40 and the plane was completely full. So I'm really blind. I wear glasses. So I didn't have my glasses on and I didn't see like the rows or anything. My sister was like, oh, like all the seats are like full. We're not gonna be able to sit next to each other. So like, okay. I don't really want to talk to anybody, so I was just going to put my headphones in and like sit there and like not talk to anyone. So I like took the first seat I found and I sat there and I put my headphones in. I'm sitting there and I felt like a tap on my shoulder and I turned and I was like, oh, the guy next to me is really, really attractive. So I was sitting there and I was like, oh, okay. So I took my headphone out and I was like, yeah. He's like, do you want the armrest up or down? I'm like, oh, it doesn't matter. And I put my headphone back in and I was like, why did I not talk to him? Anyways, so I just sat there and I was like, okay, it's fine. So I'm sitting there, I'm like waiting for the plane to take off, and I felt another tap on my shoulder. So I'm like, okay, I took my headphone out, I look over, and he like wrote a note, because I wasn't really talking. And so he like just said like, hi, like I'm Cruz, and like introduced himself. And then I was like, okay, and put my headphone back in, because I don't like talking to people apparently. And so I'm sitting there, and we're like about to take off, and we finally get in the air, and taps on my shoulder again. I take my headphone out. I'm like, okay, hi. He offered me gummy worms. I was like, you know what? I deserve it. I'll take gummy worms. So I take the gummy worms, and I'm eating the gummy worms. And we talked for like the whole flight for 2 hours. And he had no idea that I was like really sad. So he was kind of like weird that I was like not talking. But he like got over it and kept trying to talk to me. So, we're sitting there and the guy next to us is watching some like really weird show. It's got like a jungle and like a desert and there's like drug lords and like it's super weird, so we started like making words to it. So we're like, oh, like the, and the guy like next to us is like looking at us super weird. And then the light comes on for like the descending, you know, when like the light turns on for the seatbelts. So I was like, oh no, like I don't like landing. And so like the light comes on and I'm like sitting there getting really anxious, and then there's still like a cute guy next to me, so I'm like really nervous still. And then he was like, oh, like is it your first time flying alone? And I was like, yeah, it's my first time flying alone. And he was like, oh, okay. And so like held my hand when we like landed. And I'm 16 by the way, so I was like, okay. And so we like land and everything. And we're waiting for everyone to get off the airplane. He's like, oh, I had a really good time with you on the airplane. Like, I would love to get your number so we can talk later. So we like get off the airplane, we exchange information and everything. And we're looking for my sister. So he's running around the airport yelling my sister's name, like trying to find her. It was really weird. But anyways, that was 2 years ago and we've been dating ever since.